Hello, this is Sandra Hart, and welcome to Life Over 60 with Sandra. Christmas time. In my mind, I close my eyes, and I dream of hearing Santa's reindeer's hoofs on the roof like I did as a child. I close my eyes and I see the tiny white flakes falling from the sky. I hold out my tongue and I let them melt. At this time of year, I bring the child within me out and I experience all the wonder that the world has to give. Isn't this exciting? We're almost at the Christmas season, just a few days away, and I am so excited. Arthur is coming home after the first of the year. My daughter will be here in a couple of days, and I haven't seen her in over 2 years. So there is going to be a big celebration right here that I can be happy that at least one of my children has come to visit at Christmas. This time of year is a very special time of year, isn't it? It's when we are getting to the end of the year. We can reflect on all of the events that have occurred this year, whether we have grown, what good things have happened to us, and maybe what hurdles we've jumped and what doors have been slammed and maybe doors that we have been able to open again. Life really is a journey, isn't it? And when I think about what has happened to me this year, all of the things that maybe were wonderful, getting, you know, a wonderful community like you, over 100,000 subscribers, which I never thought in my wildest dreams would ever happen. Arthur coming back, leaving, and then wanting to come back, but being very satisfied that he was able to make that trip. My son and his wife and my granddaughter have visited me twice this year, so that also has been a great blessing. I have to always think about the positive and not dwell on the negative, because negative things always just drag us down, don't they? So today and on Christmas morning when you wake up, I hope you will think of your life and be so grateful for all the things in your life, and even be grateful for those lessons that we have had to learn. I know I am. Because I know life is not static, and I know that life is not all euphoria and wonderful, wonderful things, because it's not real. All of us have those hiccups in life. But if we dwell not on the hiccups, but if we dwell on those gifts that we've been given throughout our lives and throughout this year especially, then it makes Christmas and the end of the year something really to be excited about. And we're looking forward to the new year. And I hope as we grow this community and as we get to know one another even more, that we all will strive to lead more purposeful lives, not be invisible, and know that each of us matters, because each of us really has a special gift to give, whether it's to our family, our neighbors, the world. You never know. You never know what is going to bring tomorrow, what gifts are going to be there. So our gift and our gifts really don't just happen on Christmas Eve or Christmas Day. Our gifts happen every single day we wake up and we are here and we're able to experience all the wonders of life on our journey. Thank you for being here. I am so grateful for each and every one of you. I hope you will do something absolutely fabulous, fantastic for yourself today. And of course, be kind and share the Christmas love and spirit with everyone that crosses your path. And of course, let's share the love in this very troubled world that we are in right now. Thank you again. I love you all. I can't wait to see you next week, and have a wonderful, wonderful Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Kwanzaa, and wherever you are in the world, have a beautiful, beautiful day.